Obsidian is great, plugins are awesome, but there are more things to make Obsidian even better for you. Here are two of them. I found this one on Reddit, posted by user Charming Thunderstorm. It is a CSS snippet that hides the properties in reading view, shows them when hovering, and keeps them open if you click into any of them for editing. Let me show you how that works. First, let's see the default behavior of properties in the reading view. As you can see, they are expanded. You can click on the properties heading to collapse them. Now, we go to Settings, Appearance, and scroll all the way down to the CSS Snippets section. Click on the folder icon. This should open a local folder containing the snippets. Create a new file and give it a name that makes sense to you. I will call it Hide Properties. Make sure that the file extension is CSS. If you don't see your file extensions, click on View, Show, and File Name Extensions. Now open the file and copy the CSS code in there. You will find a link to all the code snippets in the description. Save the file, go back to Obsidian and refresh the list of snippets. Enable the Hide Properties one, and that should do it. If we now go back to our node, we will see that the properties are hidden. When we hover, they expand, and if we don't click into one of them, they will automatically collapse when we move the mouse away. If we edit the property, they stay open, of course. The next tip comes from GitHub user SilentVoid13. It is a template script that makes it really fast and easy to add callouts. Now, I know that this can also be done via the command palette, but bear with me, you will see the advantages in a moment. For this to work, we need to create a new template in our designated templates folder. I will call it template callouts. Then we need to copy paste the template code into it. Once again, the link is in the description. Important note here, make sure to paste the code as plain text. Otherwise, template will run into a passing error. Now we need to define a hotkey for this template. As always, we go to the Obsidian settings, template, and add new hotkey for template. We select the callouts template and click on the plus icon next to it. In the hotkey settings, search for callouts, click the plus symbol and pick any shortcut you like that does not interfere with existing settings. For this demo, I will choose Ctrl+Shift+C. Let's close the settings and create a new node. I press Ctrl+Shift+C and the script asks me several things, starting with what kind of callout I want to create. I will choose example. Then I can define the folding state of the callout. For me, it's default expanded. Now I have the option to add a title like example callout and a content text. This can have multiple lines, but note that you need to hit Shift and Enter to create a new line. Then I hit Enter or click the Submit button and my callout is ready. What I like most about this is that it's super fast and gives me a list of callout types to choose from. Combined with the Callout Manager plugin, this gives me full flexibility and makes the use of callouts very efficient. I hope you found these two quick tips useful, and I'm constantly searching for more, so maybe you have some that you would like to share with me, so I can share it with a lot of other people. I would appreciate it. It's just so much easier to improve together rather than alone. If you found this video even remotely helpful, perhaps drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring the notification bell to make sure you won't miss the next videos. All this should help you to customize and fine-tune your very own flavor of Obsidian to match your individual needs and preferences. You may also want to check out my other Obsidian videos in this growing playlist. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.